Thank you, Ms. Rush. May I have roll call, please?
Could you do it?
Here. Our first item on the agenda this evening is from the Superintendent of Schools.
Thank you, Madam President.
I don't worry.
Resolution A is to approve submission of the general fund budget for the 2012-2013 school year to voters of the district at the annual meeting to be held on Tuesday, May 15, 2012.
Can I have a motion? Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Perkash?
Yes.
Ms. Rash?
Yes.
Mr. Gansley?
Yes.
Mr. Wendell?
Yes.
Ms. Perkash?
Yes. Everyone, please turn your microphones on.
Resolution B is to approve submission of the budget for the Newburgh Free Library for the 2012-2013 school year to voters of the district at the annual meeting to be held on Tuesday, May 15, 2012.
May I have a motion? Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Yes.
Yes.
Resolution C is to approve the school lunch fund for 2012-2013 school year.
I believe we have to add Resolution C to the agenda.
Okay.
It wasn't the published agenda. Yeah.
So you want to read it first, and then I'll reread it.
Can I have a motion to add Resolution C and Resolution D to the agenda?
Second.
Roll call, please.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Mr. Perkash?
Yes.
Ms. Rash?
Yes.
Mr. Gansley?
Yes.
Mr. Wendell?
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you. Resolution C is to approve the school lunch fund for the 2012-2013 school year.
Any motion? Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Yes.
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 Resolution D. Property tax report card for the 2011-2012 school year. 2012-2013. All right. Now, we have to make an adjustment in that because of the additions that were made tonight. So that number, the total proposed spending of $2,227,000, etc., is not what we're approving. We're approving $228,476,702. Can I conduct your vote, Madam President?
Can I have a motion? Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Yes.
May I have a motion to adjourn the special meeting?
Second.
Roll call, please.
Yes.
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 We'll now begin this evening's board workshop. First item on the agenda is from the Board President. I have no agenda items this evening. Next on the agenda is from the Superintendent.
Thank you, Madam President. First report is from other presentations from Marlon Daly, before you, District Architects.
Understanding. additional manpower to clean your rooms. Do you have 2011 or 2012?
Where are you going? I'm sorry.
Excuse on the change orders.
Which was in this?
The barrels.
Yes. This is in the back of the big book from that. Is that?
Which one are you looking at now?
41 and 42 under protest. Manpower to assist the district in cleaning rooms during spring break. Is that this year now? Or is that how? We're just getting charged now for stuff that was done a year ago?
We're just processing the paperwork that we got.
From a year ago?
Correct. These are things that we found when we went to our closeout meetings. The other ones, when you go to the bottom, the two that I just mentioned, items 49 and 50, were actually for the scaffolding work that was done as a part of the first curtain wall removal that was done. This is some of the information that we're just now receiving and going through and finalizing the negotiations on that had not yet been finalized.
And we're just finding out about it because someone else was responsible for doing this paperwork and it wasn't done.
That's what we're paying an oversight person each month, not a year. I would like, if possible, because I don't want to waste the board's time tonight. We have a building and ground meeting, I think, Mr. Velez, before the board meeting next week.
Yes.
Is it possible that I could email you some things, and then could you commit to that before we go to our board meeting?
I won't be able to attend that meeting, but if you want to send some items through, certainly I can get responses to you on those.
So then you can discuss it?
Yes, and if you forward those to the superintendent, he'll get those to me, and I can handle that.
Okay.
Yep.
Rather than lose time to turn it
around,
a couple of issues that aren't there. So the answer to that, Mr. Boyd might have discussed earlier.
Yeah, no problem.
Okay.
Yeah,
thank you.
Any other, Mr. Levinstein?
Tally, just a general question. This money that we're spending with the change orders and the projects that we're doing is all from the bond issues, the bonds that we had issued a few years ago?
Correct. It's all part of the budgets that we have set up for those. I do have an update on those for you this evening as well.
Well, okay, but my question generally is that was quite a few years ago. Basically, how much money is left there to spend? And how long are the projects going to continue to go? I'm glad that we have money saved and we're doing new things with it. That's great that we can do additional projects. But how much actually is left of that bond money that we can spend?
That's the update I'm going to provide for next month. Part of what we're doing is working our way through some of these old and open change orders so we can work our way through those. Obviously, we're tracking where we're going with the work that we're doing now. We still have some work left to bid, but I can give you an update at the next meeting to answer that question more specifically. I can tell you that with the exception of some of the additional work that we're looking at now, the intent is to complete the work that was originally planned to be done by the end of this calendar year. There will be some things that we may not be able to get to because we've got to go to SED for some of this additional work that may be done after that. But the goal is to have everything done so we can afford to be done this calendar year.
Thank you.
Other questions for Mr. Bain?
Resolution B is to approve facilities project change orders associated with approved projects. South Middle School renovation project, the Gans renovation project, Bales Gate renovation project, set 1 and set 2, and Gardner Town renovation project.
Questions on any of these?
Negotiations on. We did that and they were modified and brought forward for the final resolution. Change orders 49 and 50 under South Junior High have been provided the placeholders, if you will, with $10,000 for each. And there was scaffolding that was required to be provided rather than the work being done from lifts. When we realized we had that panel behind that exterior metal panel that had to be abated, scaffolding had to be provided so the abatement contractor could set up on the scaffolding, tent in the area, and remove those panels. You probably remember the other change orders going forward that were provided to the abatement contractor to do that same thing. So this was a change that we have not yet finalized our negotiations on, so you'll see these two numbers likely change, but I wanted to get them on the resolution. We'll finalize our negotiations. I'll provide an email like I did last month's meeting with an explanation as to where we ended up. If we're not able to bring those to closure, I'll simply pull them.
Are we expecting those to go down?
I don't know. That's I took a middle ground with what we have.
Any other questions on those?
C is a resolution to amend and extend an existing agreement with CSR to provide all services related to the repackaging, rebidding, expanded construction administration services for the abatement and replacement of the boys' gym ceiling at the NFA North Campus.
Questions or comments on this item?
Comments?
Mr. Damon.
Thank you, Mr. Pinsley. Our next item on the agenda is from the Assistant Superintendent for Student Intervention and Support Services.
Thank you, Madam President. Item A is the recommendations from the Committee on Special Education.
Questions or comments? Okay.
Item B is a resolution. Facility use requests from six organizations. And these will also be brought to the Buildings and Grounds Committee next week. We haven't had a chance to discuss it yet, but we will.
Ms. Prokash?
I just have one question, Doctor. The textbook quality.
Yes.
I noticed that they put in for NFA field. And I know we've just redone that field and so on. But we have a viable field at Temple Hill that could be used.
The new field?
The new field. And it's a New Windsor club that wants this, and that's located in New Windsor rather than on the NFA field. Maybe we can put it there and that's less used there.
I believe that, and we could discuss that with Buildings and Grounds Committee meeting, that at this time there's still a need to keep the field at Temple Hill not used yet, give it some additional time before we can commit to using it.
Who said that?
I've talked to Mr. Bellis and...
I'll follow that up at tomorrow's construction meeting because I was not aware of that.
Students are using it, I know high school they're using it, they're out playing on it.
I believe Temple Hill's been released, that we have all of our final.
The metal that was from, right?
Yeah. Right. I'll verify that tomorrow, Dr. Yes.
I'd rather see them run on the grass than run on the park than the
district. We also want to ask about the. The softball field also, so I'll do that tonight also. Softball field at South Middle School. Because I thought most of that field was ready for use, but I verify that information.
And then we can add to the conversation. Okay.
Thank you.
Any other questions? Yes, Mr. Woodhull. But that was only a small portion of that field, because we asked very recently because the staff there was asking about the use of the field. And there's only a corner of the field that is not usable. So I just need to verify. I'm pretty sure that the softball field is, the bulk of the field is ready for use, but I'll verify that tomorrow. Questions on the facilities use request?
The next item, Madam President, is a resolution to expand an already approved consultant agreement to continue to provide professional development and psychiatric evaluations as needed. We would be adding $5,000, already $5,000.
Questions or comments on this item? Yes, Ms. Prokash.
Is that because they're going to be doing more for more people?
Yes, just to be prepared for the end of the year, to be prepared to respond to any requests for evaluations of students with disabilities or any professional development needed by staff who will be dealing with those students.
So they'll be working more staff?
The professional development will be provided to the staff so that they can better deal with the students, yes.
But is this additional staff, Dr. Miranda, or staff that's already received?
Staff we had who is already with us, and they may need to be prepared to provide interventions that they are ready to prepare. So they are provided the professional development, and that benefits the students.
Right, but they, but this particular staff that you're talking about, the additional professional development, hasn't already been trained. This is new training for
new staff who hasn't been professionally developed yet.
Okay. Any other questions?
The next item is a resolution to also extend a consultant agreement already approved in the amount of $25,000, and we will be adding $12,000 for a total of $37,000. And the purpose is to provide assistance in the development of functional behavior assessments and behavioral intervention plans.
Same thing, Dr. Maria.
Yes. And the source of both is IDEA funds.
Any questions or comments? Thank you, Dr. Maria. Thank you, Dr. Maria. The next item on the agenda is from the Assistant Superintendent for Curriculum and Instruction.
Thank you, Madam President. The first item this evening is a resolution to authorize the superintendent of schools to execute an agreement with Orange County Employment and Training Administration for the Summer Youth Employment Program Worksite Contract. Funding sources are 2012 Summer Youth Employment Program.
Next week.
trip is for the participation of the NFA One Campus Peer Leadership Sherpa to attend an overnight trip to Top Rock Forest in Cornwall from May 16th through the 18th. Funding source donations and student activities.
Questions?
That completely answers my question.
Thank you, Mr. Forget. Next item on the agenda is from Assistant Superintendent Finance.
Thank you, Madam President. First resolution to authorize payment of property tax refund as a result of court orders. There are six of them totaling $132,703.64.
Okay.
Item B is a resolution to approve the bid for spring athletic transportation.
Yes, Ms. Prokash.
So I just had a couple questions. One, I noticed that on the very first page, it's four of our students. I noticed there was a lot of the different role for my cross. You know, what are you doing on those runs? So,
they would go, if there's no bid, what we would normally do is see if we can talk to one of our existing contractors. I don't know why there was no bid for these. Maybe there was no bus available at the time. But I can certainly look into that.
And the other thing is, I noticed that which I really like to see, the JV and varsity traveling together to games. But I noticed the one at Middletown,
item C is a resolution to declare equipment surplus and obsolete and to authorize disposition of the same.
Questions?
Okay. And item D is a resolution to accept the monthly bills and reports.
Okay.
Thanks, Madam.
Thank you, Mr. Pasella. Next item on the agenda is from the Assistant Superintendent for Human Resources.
Thank you, Madam President. On the Human Resources agenda, items A through H, we have on the professional side, change of status, home teacher appointments, return from leave of absence, retirement, Schedule J rescissions, and on the civil service side, we have appointments, change of location, and former employees who passed away.
Questions?
Resolution I is a resolution to adopt the revised 2011-2012 district calendar. This revision is to, since we had excessive emergency days, because we didn't use the snow days, this will put back the three remaining emergency days, and those days will be Thursday, May the 24th, Friday, May the 25th, and Tuesday, May the 29th.
On that. Do you want me to go back, Ms. Prokash?
Yeah, I just wanted to get back to the session. We do.
Discuss that in executive session.
Mm-hmm. Sure. And then another question is, these days, is the walk staff?
Yes. Resolution J is to approve an appointment for the Project Hope after-school program. Funding sources, McKinney-Vento, This is one additional appointment for that after-school program. Resolution K is to approve appointments for the MFA Progressive Academy Tutorial Program. And Resolution L is for your information. It's upcoming tenure recommendations for an administrator and teachers.
Thank you, Mrs. Lila. Be it resolved that the board hereby recesses into executive session for the following purposes: to consider matters made confidential by FERPA, and to discuss the employment history of particular individuals, and a current litigation matter, Newburgh and Large City School District versus the Palomo Group. The board may take action after the executive session. Can I have a motion?
Resolutions to add to the agenda tonight. And we're calling in what number? What letters?
E, F.
Resolution E and F.
Can I have a motion to add resolutions E and F to the agenda?
So moved.
Second. Roll call, please. Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Krupkash?
Yes.
Ms. Resch?
Yes.
Mr. Whittle?
Yep.
Ms. Richek? Yes.
The resolution E is to be resolved that the resolution approved by the Board of Education on March 22nd, authorizing the law firm of Shore Pearls and Manny Lambert, LLP, to commence litigation on behalf of the school district against the Palumbo Group in the nature of a replevant action, and to seek a declaratory judgment regarding the contract with the Palumbo Group, is hereby amended to include litigation to recover the monies paid by the school district.
Can I have a motion?
Don't move. Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Krupkash?
No.
Ms. Resch?
Yes.
Mr. Whittle?
Yes.
Ms. Mitchell?
Yes.
Okay, resolution F. Be it resolved that the board hereby appoints Mr. Kenneth Swanson to serve as the district's authorized resolution session representative for the 2011-2012 school year and special education impartial hearing requested. And be it further resolved that Mr. Swanson shall have the authority to enter into resolution session settlement agreement on behalf of the board, subject to the board's right to reject any such agreement within 3 business days of execution. And be it further resolved that Mr. Swanson shall be directed by the superintendent of schools to immediately provide a copy of any resolution session agreement to the superintendent and district clerk for transmittal to and consideration by the entire board. And be it finally resolved that the resolution session agreement entered into by Mr. Swanson on April 18, 2012, is hereby ratified.
And a motion?
So moved.
Second. Questions or comments? Roll call, please. Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Krupkash?
Yes.
Ms. Resch?
Yes.
Mr. Whittle?
Yes.
Ms. Richek? Yes. Can I have a motion to adjourn?
So moved.
Second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. All those opposed? Thanks, everybody.